Hello students, I hope you have studied lesson number 1 to 6. Now we are starting a new chapter, that is lesson number 7, Interdependence in Living Beings. Interdependence means that the living animals and plants are interconnected to each other. They are depending on each other. Plants, they are the producers. They give food to us, and they can only prepare their own food with the help of photosynthesis. Here in this chapter, you will learn plants as a producer, interdependence of plants and animals, how they depend to each other, balance in nature, and animals as consumers. As you know, there are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers, and decomposers. And last, you will study food chain. And there are few ecological imbalances in nature due to natural disasters as well as man-made occurring. So let's begin this chapter with a warm-up. Here you can identify the living things in the following picture. Can you circle them? Here you have a girl doll. Okay, it's a toy, so it's a non-living thing. Then you have some books. Books are also non-living thing. Then there is rubber, non-living thing. But children, remember, rubber is coming from a rubber plant. Okay, so though it is a non-living thing, but it is coming from a living plant. Then you have a tulsi plant. Can you see a tulsi plant? So this is a living plant. Your pencil box, your pencil is a non-living thing. Your mobile phone is also a non-living thing. The motorbike is also a non-living thing. So living things, animals, you can see dog, tiger, zebra, and an insect is there, that is butterfly. Okay, here you have write 4 differences you observe between plants and animals. See, one difference is the most important, that plants can produce their own food, animals cannot. Plants are totally dependent on animals because they are giving carbon dioxide, and that carbon dioxide is used by plants for their food. Then animals are taking oxygen, which is being released by plants. So animals are taking oxygen for breathing. And last, you can say the difference is plants cannot move, but animals can move. Number 2, do plants and animals depend on each other? Explain with an example. Yes, they do. They totally depend on each other, as I told you, in breathing, in respiration. Animals need oxygen, plants need carbon dioxide for their making their food in the sunlight. Plants breathe oxygen at night, so they are totally dependent to each other. Herbivores, carnivores, these are the some categories in which the animals are divided due to their habitats, eating habit. Now we know that plants make their own food. Animals depend on plants for their food and other things. Similarly, plants also depend on animals for some basic needs. Let us discuss about plants and animals and how they depend on each other. Plants as producers. Green plants make their own food as well as for animals and human beings. Hence, plants are called producers. To make their food, they use energy from sunlight. They also need water and carbon dioxide for making food. So, what is required for plants to produce their food? That is carbon dioxide, water. Green plants only can produce this photosynthesis. They can perform photosynthesis just because of the green chlorophyll. Okay, that is present in their chloroplast, in their leaf. Okay, green color plants, green color leaf only produces and perform photosynthesis. So they make their own food, use this energy, sunlight, okay, sunlight energy to synthesize food, to create food. Now the role of leaves. What is the role of leaves? Different plants have different types of leaves. We can identify a plant by looking at its leaves. Leaves are generally green in color due to presence of chlorophyll in them. As I told you, the green chlorophyll is present. It's a pigment. It helps in absorbing all the sunlight and gives out energy to the leaf cells. Leaves of some plants like croton have chlorophyll, but they appear red. Okay, as you can see in the leaf, this is croton, and somewhere there is red in color. Okay, they appear red because they contain a red substance that hides the green color. Such leaves also prepare food for the plants as they contain chlorophyll. Leaves make food for the plant, hence they are known as food factory or kitchen of the plant. On the other side of the leaf, there are many tiny holes called stomata. Stomata help plant in gaseous exchange. Thus, a leaf helps the plant to make food and for gaseous exchange through stomata. Now let's begin with photosynthesis. The food making process of the plants is called photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide, sunlight, water, and chlorophyll are the raw materials that are needed for this process. Requirements for this photosynthesis. Number one is sunlight. Sunlight is the basic requirement for the photosynthesis because it provides energy. In this process, every single cell of the plant, of the leaf, is having chlorophyll, which absorb the sunlight and perform photosynthesis. They get energy from sunlight. Water is also needed and is absorbed from the soil through roots, by roots of the plant. So roots are absorbing water and helping the leaf to use that water in process of photosynthesis. Soil contains essential nutrients also. So the nutrients are also being absorbed with the water by roots and supplied to the plant. Carbon dioxide, plant need it from the air in the form of a gas. Okay, they take this gas from the stomata. The leaf, if you can see, the leaf, inside the leaf, the below the leaf, under the leaf, there is some pores. These pores are stomata, the openings. These openings help to take oxygen and give out, to take carbon dioxide and give out oxygen at the daytime, in the daytime. So this is what is done during photosynthesis. So then chlorophyll is just a pigment which is very important in absorbing this energy of sunlight. It's just like a solar cell. The solar cell absorbs and The plant leaf cell is having chlorophyll, which is absorbing the sunlight energy and helping the leaves to perform photosynthesis. This is just like in kitchen, we need LPG cylinders to ignite our stoves. Okay, so the fuel is the sunlight and the stove is the chlorophyll and the whole kitchen is the leaf. Okay, so the leaf is performing the making of food in plants. Now children, see, this is the diagram which is showing photosynthesis, how it occurs. It starts from the roots. The roots are absorbing, the plant draws up water and minerals from the soil. The water is going to all parts of the plant from the roots, and the leaf is also absorbing carbon dioxide from air through the openings that is called stomata in the leaf. Here what you will see that all the leaves are green in color, which is the significant role playing in photosynthesis, that is the chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is absorbing the energy of the sun and giving energy to each cell to perform the photosynthesis, to make sugar, by carbon dioxide, from carbon dioxide and water. So actually what is happening, there is a water breakdown. Water is being broken into oxygen and the hydroxyl, the other part of the water, is being synthesized with carbon dioxide to form sugar. So this is what is happening in the photosynthesis. So water and carbon dioxide both are the essential, we can say, the raw material which is needed for this food preparation. So starch, in the form of starch, the food is prepared in every leaf. So this is what photosynthesis is. So let us know more about the food prepared by the plant is in the form of a simple sugar. It is used in the number of ways. Number one, to get energy to carry out a number of processes for the growth of the plant. Extra food is stored in the form of the starch in different parts of the plant, such as root, stem, flowers, leaves, fruits and seeds, which we eat. Okay, we eat that part of a plant where food is stored, like for example potato, okay, the stem part, the carrot, the root part, and we eat tomato, it's a fruit. Okay, so these are some of the food which is being prepared by the leaves, and it is the extra food which humans and animals are consuming in their daily life. So let us recall right true and false for the statements. Plants can make their own food. It is true. All plants depend on animals for food. It is false. Okay, all plants do not depend on animals. Okay, there are few plants which do not have chlorophyll in them, or they do not get enough sunlight, so they become carnivorous, like for example sundew or Venus flytrap. Okay, they eat insects, they digest them and they get the nourishment, nitrogens, they get the proteins from these insects. So some plants, they do not produce food, but many plants on this earth, they prepare their own food through photosynthesis. So number two is false. Number three, stomata are present on the underside of a leaf. So yes, it is true, underside, okay, just beneath. Then number four, leaves make food for a plant. Yes, it is true. Leaves take in oxygen through the stomata to make food for the plant. Plants release oxygen. They do not take oxygen for making photosynthesis, for making starch. They use carbon dioxide and water to prepare their own food. So this is false. Now animals as consumers, as animals cannot make their own food, they depend on the plants for their food. Hence they are called consumers. Animals including human beings get their energy from the food they eat. Some animals eat plants or plant products. Some animals eat flesh and milk of these plant-eating animals. Thus all animals depend on each other. Directly or indirectly, they depend on plants. Their basics of eating habits. Animals are divided into three groups. They are herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Herbivores, as you know, all animals that eat green plants, green grass, like cow, goat, horse, sheep, elephant, zebra. There are many herbivores. Okay, there are like rabbit, okay, squirrel. They are herbivores. Okay, they eat plant or plant products. So they are herbivores. They are also called primary consumers because they are the first consumers for these plants, and plants are producers. Okay, all animals are consumers. They don't prepare their own food. They take only plant food. Now, next we have carnivores. Animals that eat only flesh of other animals are called carnivores. All wild animals, carnivores like to hunt other animals for their own food. Tigers, lion, crocodile, snake, and wolves are examples of carnivores. Then you have omnivores. Animals that eat both plants and animals are called omnivores. Human being is also called omnivore. Dog, bear, pig, and crow are examples of omnivore. Okay. Let us recall. Write true and false for the following statements. Elephant is a herbivore. Yes, it is true. Cow and goat are milk and meat producing animals. Yes, it is true. Human being is an example of omnivore animal. Yes, it is also true. Lions and tigers are omnivores. It is false. Lion and tiger both are carnivores. A train is considered as living thing because it can move. No. It's a man-made object. The train moves because of the energy of electricity or coal. It runs on a coal also. Okay, in hilly areas, but mostly it run on electricity. So it is a non-living thing. It's not a living thing. A plant cannot move from one place to another. So it is a non-living thing. Plant, though it cannot move, but it is a living being because it can perform to prepare own food. It can grow from a seed to a new plant, from a new plant to a big tree. Okay, so it bears fruits also. It gives food. Now we have come to the main topic of this chapter, that is interdependence of plants and animals. How they interdependent to each other. Plants and animals depend on each other in many ways. Plants and animals help to maintain the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the environment by exchange of gases. Plants give out oxygen. This oxygen is needed by animals for breathing. Animals give out carbon dioxide, which is needed by plants for photosynthesis. Animals depend directly or indirectly on plant for their food. Herbivores eat plants and carnivores eat flesh of the herbivores. Thus, a chain of living organism called a food chain exists in nature. So, children, you know that plants are the producers, and these plants are being eaten by the herbivores, and the herbivores are being hunted by these carnivores. And when carnivores die, they decay, they are eaten by scavengers. Okay, scavengers are given in the book. See, these are scavengers. These scavengers, they eat dead and decaying animals. Those plants and animals which are dead, they eat on them. For example, vulture, crow, housefly, hyena are scavengers. They play an important role in cleaning the environment. After the scavengers, there comes decomposers. These decomposers, like bacteria, fungi, earthworm, whatever the remaining decaying matter of these dead plants and animals which are left remaining, these decomposers, they decompose them to minerals. They release nutrients, and minerals into the soil, which are essential for the plants. So this whole situation is completed, the food chain is completed with decomposers. They decompose the minerals back to the soil, and the soil again get nourished, and new baby seeds, plants grow again. So the consumers are there, okay, primary consumers. These plants are eaten by herbivores, then again herbivores are eaten by carnivores, then carnivores, they are hunted, they are dead, then scavengers, they occupy their dead decaying matter, and the remaining decaying matter is being decomposed by decomposers like bacteria, fungi and these earthworms. So this is what is given here. It's a simple chain, food chain. Could start with grass, which is eaten by rabbits, then the rabbits are eaten by foxes. Here grass is the producer, rabbit is the primary consumer, and the fox is the secondary consumer. Maybe in the jungle, fox can be eaten by the tiger, and when the tiger is old enough, it will die and decompose. Then scavengers like crow, vulture, they will feed on him, feed on the dead tiger. So this is what is happening in the nature, which creates a balance in the ecosystem. The balance between the number of the plants and the animals in nature needs to be maintained. If there is a sudden increase in the number of animals, the food and the oxygen supply by plants may not be sufficient for animals, which create imbalance in nature, imbalance in ecosystem. Now let's do this. Can you form the correct food chains for the following? Write down in the space given below. First one is, correct order is the plant, then the plant is being eaten by the bug. Bug is an insect, and the bug is eaten by the chicken. Then number one is grass. Grass is a primary producer, okay, it produces food. That grass is eaten by goat, and goat is being eaten by man. Then grass, grasshopper and rat. Last one is frog eaten by snake, and snake eaten by an eagle. So here it is, if there is a sudden decrease in the number of animals, then carbon dioxide supplied by animals may not be sufficient for plants. So this is what is called dependent. Both plants and animals are in balance. So the plant should be a huge in number, producers should be huge in number, so that animals have enough amount of food. Carbon dioxide animals are producing, so plants will absorb it. They will produce food with the help of carbon dioxide. Thus, we need to protect both plants and animals. Ecosystems are organized in a state of balance where one species coexists with the other species and also with the environment. Ecological imbalance occurs when a natural or man-made cause disturbs the natural balance of an ecosystem. So this is what is happening here. So the natural disasters, natural causes are volcanic eruption. You know, there are tectonic plates, there are volcanoes. Beneath the earth, there is lava, which melts, which can come out anytime due to high pressure. So volcanic eruptions cause destruction. They release a lot of gases, which creates pollution. Okay, then floods, heavy rainfall, which is occurring in this season also, in July, August. So everywhere we see here, we see floods, okay, due to excessive rainfall. So these are the causes of natural disaster. Then there are tsunami, when the tectonic plates beneath the sea, they shatter, the earthquake occurs, which creates the vibration in the under the sea, which makes some of the vibrations so loud that the sea becomes like tsunami. Okay, they come to the shore, so they come to the sea beaches and creates tsunami. Cyclone occurs, mortal shape cyclone, which create disaster, which funnel shape cyclones, which are causing disaster to like countries like America. There are very common cyclones, tornadoes. Then drought, mostly in Uttar Pradesh, where we stay, there the area is having natural disaster, that is drought. The water level is going down, there is scarcity of rainfall. So this is what is happening these days. Natural disaster is causing the imbalance in nature, which is harming plants and animals and creating ecological imbalance. Then there are man-made causes also. Earlier, men used to have a habit of hunting. So hunting and poaching leads to reduction of number of animals and extinction of many species. Poaching, it's illegal hunting, okay? So there are firms, fishing firms, there are illegal hunting over the oceans. They are killing whales, they are killing sharks, they are killing big animals, they are for money making. They are creating imbalance in nature. Some are deforesting. Some businessmen, they are creating deforestation and leading to the loss of vegetation, plus the animals are losing their habitats, they are losing their home. Wild animals, they live in forest, and due to deforestation, just because to build factories over there, just to build hotels and resorts over there, these businessmen are creating disaster to the ecological system. Then humans are creating pollution also. Many factories are emitting harmful gases, which like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide. They are creating acid rain also, which is harming various monuments like Taj Mahal. So natural disaster is also occurring, imbalances in nature plus man-made causes, like introduction of a new species. Scientists are creating new species of animals also. Okay, they are creating new viruses also. They are creating imbalance in nature. As you know, this is the time of coronavirus. Everybody is saying that this is a man-made virus. Maybe it is true. America is saying that China had created it in their Wuhan laboratory, but China is regretting it. So maybe in future we will know it. What is the truth? So human, with its eagerness to achieve success, the country wants to be number one in the world. They are putting the humankind and ecosystem in danger. So this is what this chapter is creating awareness for the future, that you have to take care of plants and animals together, because both are needed, both are important. We have to take care of both these living organisms. We have to create balance in production of plants, production of trees, as well as production of animals. So this is what the chapter is. Let's do the question answers and few of the exercises. Take the correct answer. Number one is chlorophyll. The green colored substance present in leaves is chlorophyll. Which of the following are decomposers? That is fungi. Animals that eat dead and decaying animals and plants are known as scavengers. Which is not a natural cause of ecological imbalance? That is deforestation. Name the following process. The process by which green plants make their own food is photosynthesis. The green pigment present in plants is chlorophyll. Animals that eat both plants and animals are called omnivores. Food factory of plants is leaves. A chain that shows that flow of nutrients and energy among the living organism is called food chain. Animals that feed on dead and decaying animals and plants are called scavengers. Let's do true and false. Scavengers are another type of consumers that help in cleaning environment. This is true. Food chain always starts with producers. This is also true. A balanced ecosystem has more trees and less animals. This is true. Hunting, poaching, and deforestation are some of the natural causes of ecological imbalance. No, it is done only by humankind, man. Man-made imbalance, okay, man-made causes of imbalance in nature. Animals get fresh oxygen from plants. This is true. Now let's do match the columns. Vulture is B, scavenger. Grass, this is C, producer. Grasshopper, this is number E, that is primary consumer. Tiger, this is D, secondary consumer. And bacteria, it is decomposer. Okay, so this is what is given. Then you have to draw and label a simple food chain. Okay, draw and label. In that you can draw this diagram. This is the simplest diagram which is given in the book. The grass eaten by rabbit. Grass is producer. Okay, rabbit is primary consumer, and rabbit is eaten by fox, and fox is secondary consumer. This is showing a simple food chain. So then you have some question answers and apply and analyze. Okay, these are the question answers. This I will give you a PDF file. From there you can copy that answers. Okay, all the answers are given in the PDF file, so you do that. Okay, till then you study this chapter and try to understand. If you have still any problem, you can ask. Okay, thank you.